What's going on, guys? This is Riggs from Clashing FFS, bringing you guys not only a brand new video, but a brand new series that I want to get going. As you guys see, I am on my Town Hall 9 account, dusting off the old Town Hall 9, showing the Town Hall 9 some love. And we're starting a new series, a Town Hall 9 attack guide series. A lot of these videos, the way I'm looking at it, the way I have it outlined, a lot of them are going to go kind of hand in hand. You can't really have one without the other. A lot of things overlap and so on. What we're going to be talking about in this one is base weaknesses and how to expose a weakness in a base to grab that 3-star. And if we go ahead and look at the war map, a crushing defeat from Molten Lava. Did take a loss to COC Hogwars in a random matchup. It was kind of really a funky breakdown. The Town Hall, everything was just kind of off. But nevertheless, it was a very, very good war. And I have some amazing attacks to show you guys. 5 in total. And we're going to break down the bases, show you guys what the weaknesses were in each of these bases in each 5 examples, show how they were exposed, and how the bases ended up in a 3-star. And normally, like I do with the Town Hall 9 attacks, I usually only show the fresh hits. I mean, we do, you know, every so often show a cleanup hit, but especially for learning attack strategies, that element of surprise and not knowing where the Tesla farms are, not knowing what's in the CC, not knowing where the traps are and so on, how troops are going to react to certain things. A lot of those elements you do not have in a fresh hit. So a lot of the things that you see are on the fly. So we're just going to stick to the fresh hits. And we're going to start down here at the bottom. I just want to jump right into this. Not want to do, you know, too much talking, not too much nonsense. So the first base we're going to look at right here is this base that Bolt took on. I believe this is Ray, Ratio. And again, like I said in the beginning, a lot of things go hand in hand. So when you're exposing a weakness in a base, knowing what troops are going to use, often that goes hand in hand with base identification. Identifying a base, what the base calls for, what it doesn't, and finding the weakness and exposing it. So on a base like this, you can clearly see how the Archer Queen is centered, and how if you look at these 2 air defenses right here, so bringing in something like a kill squad, not only are you gonna take out some air targeting defenses such as a couple Wizard Towers and Archer Tower right there, 2 air defenses, an Expo, a Sweeper, and the enemy queen. And look at this clan castle. Not sure what's going on there, but just dropping something like a giant or even a barbarian is going to grab a lure like that. So we're gonna go ahead and look exactly how Ratio, aka Bolt, breaks this base down. If you look at the troop bar, he's got 2 golems, has a pair of hounds, and he has 1 jump spell. When you see these compartments that are just 3 tiles wide, ideally, you're not going to want to bring something like a wall breaker, something like a jump where you have to worry about something like a wall breaker fill. Look at that jump leading right into the core of this base. You can see right there on the edge, that jump opens up 4 separate compartments, going to be taking out both of these air defenses. Like I said, grabbing an expo, and the most important thing is setting up a, breaking that defense ring and setting up nice pathing for the Lalo portion. Here comes enemy CC, goes ahead and drops down a poison for it, only brings 1. And you see he has a jump, and he did have a rage for his kill squad. And notice how he set a real nice funnel, bowlers didn't go walking. And just about half this base is gone. And here comes the Lalo, starting over here on the upper left-hand side of the base, dropping down 2 hounds on that air defense right there and dropping about anywhere from 3 to 5 loons per each one of these defenses. And you can see this nice wad of loons right here, rotating around the base, going counterclockwise. And you see those hounds are on the 4th and final air defense. Notice he's being nice and patient, guys, with that last haste. It's going to be sending all those loons into these last few air targeting defenses. And he even ends on the farm, Tessa's end up popping that hound, providing him all kinds of cleanup. Even has a couple loons for the back end right there just to distract that Tesla. And you can see he just has a whole lot of loons left up. Also has all kinds of pups to help with cleanup. Even has a Wiz, some minions. Like I said, identifying a base, knowing what the weakness is, and something like just a simple jump and a rage on that kill squad took out all kinds of objectives, got everything done, taken care of, and you see it ended up in a very, very nice three star. Now we're gonna take a look at one of my hits using something like dragons, something that a lot of people are not comfortable using. But one thing I will say is with the meta that Talon 9 is in, bases are always constantly trying to defend something like a Lalo. So you guys will see, if you haven't already, I'm sure you already have though, air defenses in all kinds of crazy positions just to make it that much harder to stop the Lalo, which is probably still to this day one of the most strongest attacks is the Lalo at Town Hall 9. So what do Town Hall 9s try to defend against? Something like a Lalo. So if you look at these air defenses, the first thing I noticed is these two air defenses right here. Just dropping down an Archer Queen, okay? Just dropping down an Archer Queen, you can, even if there's a Tesla right here, again, these hits I'm showing you guys are all fresh. Even if there's a Tesla, even if there's two Teslas right there, with a level 30 Archer Queen under ability, I know that she'll be able to take out those two air defenses. So that was the first thing I saw. Then I looked over this side, seeing how exposed this AD was, and notice I can get a really nice funnel, not only set for the dragons, but taking out this air defense and this archer tower with something like a Kiwi Walk. Riggs, what's a Kiwi Walk? That's where you, a Kiwi Walk is basically where you drop down your king and anywhere from two to say four, sometimes even five wizards, and those wizards can shoot these defenses over the wall and get rid of all these buildings right here to set a funnel for an attack. In this example, we're going to be doing it with dragons. And you, oh, and before I start, and you can also see something like here in the core, both expos right next to each other. So we know we can get really, really good value with a rage and a heal right there. Another thing with dragon attacks is, it honestly, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter where the Archer Queen is. So in this base, the Archer Queen's on the opposite end of where my dragons are gonna be starting. So that's one thing you guys don't have to worry about like with other attacks. So here comes the Archer Queen. We have the Kiwi Walk working down here. They're doing their thing, gonna take out that AD. Notice the Queen took out both air defenses, guys, from over the wall, even before I had to pop the Archer Queen ability. And you can clearly see how the funnel's already been set. And all my dragons, the only place my dragons have to go into is inside the base. Again, being a fresh hit, we didn't know what was in the CC. So I went ahead and dropped a poison, or brought a poison along, just in case there was something like a baby dragon in the clan castle. In this case, there was. So here comes the CC loons. And you'll notice I did bring a max haste donate in the clan castle. Check that out, guys. Those loons, after that mortar went down, beelined it straight for the fourth and final AD. Here comes all the loons in the core raged up. Here comes a heal spell, keep them healed up, taking out those expos. And you guys will see the entire core of this base is pretty much gutted at this point. Here comes the last rage dropped on the drag. And you can see on the back end of the base, I did see that Tesla farm pop. I did have a couple camp loons that I went ahead and dropped on those two Teslas right there. And the other thing was most of the point defenses, splash defenses do not do anything to dragons, things like wizard towers. It's mainly the point defenses and air defenses are your main concerns for dragons and trying to keep them clumped up. And as you guys saw on the entry of this base, most of the archer towers were all offset on where my dragons entered the base when they were all at full health. And most of the wizard towers were on the back end, ending up in a three star. Again, finding a weakness in the base and exposing it, picking up two air defenses and an archer tower for just a archer queen. Huge, huge, huge value. So we've already seen a shattered Lalo and a dragon attack. Now we're gonna go ahead and look at Little J. All right, and next up we have Little J
aka Jonah, going to be taking on this base. And the first thing you guys are going to notice, or the very, very first thing you guys are going to notice, is the value that you can get from a queen walk. And again, it is a queen walk shattered hobo that we bring along. And usually when you see something like a king and a queen in the same compartment, that means often when you're using hogs on the back end, you don't take care of that king. Often that level 30 king can completely wreck your hogs. So he's going to be taking advantage of having both of these heroes in the same compartment within range of the Archer Queen, and where the healers are going to be out of range of the air defense. So as you guys can see, he can take out a double cannon, both heroes, two archer towers, and a wizard tower on his queen walk. And you can, and he's going to be using this mortar and this cannon as anchors for his entry. He does have bowlers in the CC, and we're going to see him get incredible value using two jumps, where he's going to be able to take out both of the expos, again, side by side, to take out both of these expos from his kill squad. And you already know, notice he doesn't even have a heal spell. So he's investing all of the spells in his kill squad and in the queen walk. Notice he goes ahead and drops down a rage to go ahead and wipe out the enemy king. Once this DSF goes down, now he's got a poison for the enemy queen. And you'll see he's going to be taking out that double cannon, just a few shots, that goes down. So both heroes are already down at this point, has already eliminated a couple defenses as well. Here comes the golems, and notice he doesn't need to have an expensive funnel. Just a couple wizards are going to get this funnel nice and set. There goes the wall breakers, started with a test one. Just make sure there was no mini bomb right there to kill those wall breakers. Goes ahead and breaks the wall. And he does have a jump. One more poison for that baby drag Valk wizard that came out of the CC. Goes ahead and drops down his first rage. And you can see everything has met up right here. The bowlers, the golems. He's got his queen, his healers. Look at the value, guys, that he is getting from this kill squad. Notice he has a jump leading into both of those expos right there in the core. Bowler's still up. Just going to go ahead and trickle a couple hogs, as he does see once you've got over 50%, all four Teslas pop. Goes ahead and pops the king ability. And now he's just sprinkling a few hogs as the majority of the defenses are still targeting his kill squad. Look at this, golems at full health on the other end of the base, just dropping down a few hogs per each one of these defenses, guys. Still has his Archer Queen ability in the bag, and three hogs completely wrecked this base. And keep in mind, guys, like I've been saying, these are all fresh hits, not knowing where any of the traps are, not knowing the CC. So huge shout out to Little J. Getting a six pack this war. And as you guys have noticed, each one of these attacks are very different from the others. So giving you guys all kinds of variety in this video right here, doing it with a Town Hall 9 attack guide. Here's my second hit, one of my absolute favorite attacks in the game right now at Town Hall 9 is the Go Bolo. I haven't coined a funny name for it yet, but we're calling it the Go Bolo. If you look down at the troop bar, bring in four golems, doing it brimstone style, 15 wizards, 8 wounds. A couple guys saw this before I went in live, and they said, wow, they didn't even know, they hadn't seen this attack yet. They had not seen this attack. I wouldn't say it's mainstream, but it's definitely out there in other YouTube videos. Give it a try, guys. The bases you're trying to use this on is when you can get the majority of the air targeting defenses taken down from your golems and your bowlers, or your golems tanking, wizards shooting. So if you guys look at these wizard towers, all these archer towers, all here on the edges, and notice one jump, okay? One jump is going to give me access to this compartment, which gives me both air defenses right there within the compartment, and right over the wall, these four air defenses. So it's very, very heavy kill squad. And if you check it out, guys, you're only bringing 8 loons, only bringing 8 loons on this attack. And if you look at the back end, It's all ground except these two Archer towers right here on the back end. Even if there were Teslas back here, bringing a haste along will completely wreck that back end. So it all comes down to the entry. So again, we're bringing four golems on this attack. So we drop down one golem, four wizards behind, go ahead and drop down another golem, and then three more wizards. So they're gonna be setting the funnel. And with this attack, you bring bowlers in the CC, guys. On this one, we have two rage and one heal. All these spells, with the exception of the haste, is going to be used on the balloon portion. So now we got both heroes down. CC came out, did drop a poison for it. Kind of had a nasty split. Baby Drag went for the golem on the right side. Wizards took it out. But all the archers went for that golem, which we had the poison for. So here we have the jumpling everything in. We drop down the rage and the heal as they're making their way in. Notice the enemy queen is already down. Two air defenses are already down at this point. Queen is just sniping these expos. So she is going to step up and take out the fourth and final AD. There's no more air targeting defenses left, guys. We have loons on the back end hasting one of those sides there to take out that archer tower. And this base with, I mean, this is a sub 2 minute raid. Again, finding a weakness to a base and exposing it. Not that this was a bad base, but especially at Town Hall 9, for the majority of Town Hall 9 bases, there's very, very tough bases out there. But more often than not, you can find a weakness and you expose it, and you can often crush a base like we did in this attack right here, guys. Didn't lose one balloon, both heroes still up. So that right there was the Go Bolo, and you're using this attack when you can get the majority of the air targeting defenses and all four ADs down with a very, very heavy kill squad, and taking advantage of a nice funnel set for the bowlers and using the majority of your spells on that kill squad. So definitely found the weakness in that base right there. This is gonna be our last example. We're gonna be doing a Queen Charge Lalo. We got Jason 1117, AKA Goofs, guys. Gonna be doing it with a Queen Charge Lalo, which when we saw this live, as you guys are gonna see, actually, I went way ahead of myself. We already watched the attack. I'm getting way too excited right now. Okay, reason why he is going to be doing a Queen Charge. The first thing he saw is the fact that he can get rid of two Wizard Towers, two Archer Towers, and breaking into this compartment right here, where I have that right there, where he originally, as you guys are gonna see, where he originally planned his wall breaker entry. He can also get an air defense and an expo on this charge, guys. Huge, huge value. And you can see this AD layout, not too difficult for Lalo pathing. That's one thing you wanna look at, where the ADs are, and if you have good Lalo pathing. This space absolutely does. As you guys can see, there's not many questions exactly to where your balloons are going to go. We know how exactly they're gonna path, going defense to defense and approaching those air defenses, taking them out. And we're gonna see how he breaks this one down. So starting over, or I should say up at 12, Baby Dragon, just to help set the funnel, as he does want his queen to go in the right direction, which is from 12 o'clock down to 9. And not to mention, he can also get the enemy CC taken out and take out the enemy queen. As that cannon goes down, he's going to be gauging enemy queen very, very quickly. So goes ahead and drops a rage as they have a little queen on queen action like we always love. Okay, so here comes the BK. So he gets a kind of a nasty wall breaker split right there. So both wall breakers make it to the wall, but they ended up splitting, damaging each section of these walls right here. And notice Mike is also doing a Kiwi Walk, one of my absolute favorites. And since that queen is taking damage, notice those healers do not pull off of the queen. But since the Kiwi Walk eliminated all these buildings over here, the queen just shot that wall a couple times as the wall breakers damaged it. So still, even though he had a wall breaker fail, was still able to get into that compartment he originally planned to get into. Notice the expo's down, And that cannon's down. Here comes the CC, goes ahead and drops a rage and a poison to deal with it. We'd rather have that CC engage the Archer Queen than the Lala portion. So while that Queen is pretty much on cruise control at this point, still has the ability, here comes the Lalo just dropping down one camp hound and a hound coming out of the CC over at 3 o'clock. And as we saw, look at how those loons are pathing. The pathing was not too difficult for those loons to take out those air defenses. And having that hound is still up tanking this Tesla farm. Notice the Queen did break through the wall, taking out that other air defense. So Queen ended up getting both air defenses. And look at how many loons Mike has left up with just an Archer Tower. So that balloon right there, just to distract her, ended up soaking up a Seeking air mine. And you'll see right here, just has that one Archer Tower left. Queen takes out that air sweeper. She's engaged. You guys get the point. This base was completely wrecked. In this base, Mike definitely took advantage of a high value Queen Walk slash Queen Charge and taking advantage of this base with the 80 layouts, leaving optimal pathing for not only the hounds, knowing exactly where they're going to go from AD to AD, and most importantly, knowing where the loons are going to go. So that's pretty much going to be the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Starting off a new series, let me know down in the comment section below what you guys think. If you guys want to see some nice Town Hall 9 coverage, doing a Town Hall 9 attack guide. Also, let me know what attacks you'd like to see or certain things maybe you're having difficulty with, you know, just to make videos to help you guys. That's what we're here. And, you know, that's why we're doing this, to provide, you know, some fun footage for you guys. And most importantly, help you guys in your attacks at the end of the day. So, again, if you made it to the end of the video, make sure you, in the comment section below, let me know what you think of this new series, and hopefully we can continue it and keep bringing good coverage for you guys. If you liked the video, make sure you liked it, subscribe to the channel if you have not already, and always exposing Town Hall 9 weaknesses in these bases. This is Riggs from Clashing FFS, and I'll see you in the very next video.